I am back in Chinatown in the episode of showing you guys a little street along Chinatown. For those of you who are new here, right, I have a full videos about food, Chinatown food reviews. But actually, all the hidden gems is on that little street. This is the episode 2. Let's go. Most of the people coming to this street here going to eat at this place. They're going to serve that right at your table in a hot pan like this. If you like bird nest or shark fin, right, too crowded, right, and they have all the time to prepare food for you guys. That I'm showing you today is just here, right, called Thanon Paeng Nam. In the middle of Chinatown, mainly people will walk along this main street only, okay? But in today's video, right, I'm going to show you this one. There are one dish, one menu that locals like to come. To give you point of direction, this is one bank here called UOB, right? Once you see this bank, go across this crossroad and you will be here at Thanon Paeng Nam.
Actually, we're doing this video because a lot of our friends that come like traveling in Thailand, they're asking like, what can they try in Chinatown that is not those famous restaurants that like everyone trying, but they want to try something new, try something that not many people go. So that's why we wanted to do this video for you guys, because you guys are also one of our friends, and yeah.
Yeah, because most of the people we just walk in the main street, yeah. Right? Not many people going to a little street along the way. Yeah. So by watching this video, you get to experience more things about Chinatown. Right, let me start by this one here, this one called Chinese pork soup or gao lao leut mu. Basically, you can pick different part of pork and they're going to like pour the soup on top of it and you eat it with rice.
Asking people who come traveling in Thailand what kind of food they like, and a lot of them answer that they love the spring roll, the gyoza, and they have it here.
Especially from the European countries, right? Yeah. They're going to line up for this gyoza here. If you like bird nest or shark fin, right, in a little street like this, it's a little bit cheaper than the main street. It's not too crowded, right, and they have all the time to prepare food for you guys. This is very good looking fish ball, quite big. And within a short distance from the main street, right? This is my favorite, my favorite. If you see, right, most of the people coming to this street here going to eat at this place called Khua Phor Lamai. They serve everything in an extremely hot pan.
Like this.
Like this.
They're basically burning the pan right now.
Yes,
it's really hot.
Yes, yes.
Your favorite, huh?
Yes, yes. I'll show you. actually they're going to serve that right at your tables. Just like this. Alright, the main street is just there, right? And the place I'm recommending is this one. But I'm going to walk you deep down inside a little bit. All the people right sitting here and here, they order the hot pan noodles at Khua Phalamai over there. And the more you walk in, right, the more local it will be. This one is Lan Khao Tom, right? Boiled rice or rice. And basically you got a lot of side dish. Instead of expensive seafood in the main street, maybe you can try to come here and do something local. Within 5 minute walks, right? Actually, this is going to direct you to, I think this is Jalan Kung Road, but just so you know, right? This is MRT Wat Mangkon, where you can come here by subway and walk to the Chinatown this way.
Let's try this frozen cola here. Oh! It just turns from a normal cola into like kind of look like a strawberry.
Yes.
So it kind of look like a, how to say it? Like a, I don't even know how to.
In Thai we call it Kok Bun.
Kok Bun. It's like a slurpee.
Yeah, it's more like jelly, slurpee, and like frozen drink.
How much is it?
25 baht. Like regular Coke, but in a frozen way.
And after you're done eating, like you might want to get relaxed. Like aside from a normal Thai massage, you might want to try the fish massage. So you just put your feet into the tank and let all the fishes eat all your dead skin here. Actually, I tried it before, but it's too much for me. It's too tickle.
Yes. I never try one.
I can't stay for like more than 1 minute. It's too much for me.
I know. There are coconut ice cream on the main street of Chinatown, but this one is local ice cream. And the price is a little bit cheaper as well. This one, papat ice cream.
Papat.
Jelly ice cream.
Yeah,
jelly. We're tasting.
It's so good, actually. For you.
I'm fine, thank you.
I'll take two.
You know, all of this experience, this is local enough, right? Not far at all from the main Chinatown. This is the reason, right? Maybe you can consider, right? This is the second episode of Little Street in Chinatown, okay? If you do not see the first one, I will put the link in the description below and also subscribe for more local videos like this.
It tastes so good, guys. 50 baht.
The lady just gives sample to Emmy and Emmy buy the whole scoop for two.
Two scoops actually.
Emmy, get back to work. Right? Next to this ice cream cart, there are elephant pan for you.
Yeah. Elephant pan. How much?
It's 100 baht, okay?
Oh, actually cheap.
Not bad.
Oh, not this elephant pants. They also like have like normal pajamas. You can wear it. Like when you come to Thailand and you didn't pack enough, come here. So cheap here. Woo!
So right, this is Gana Chai. Wow, this is very hard for me to tell you guys, right? Maybe if you know Chinese, maybe you can type in the comment in English for you, for me, for everyone actually. Here you got soy milk, right? Or in Thai it's called Nam Tau Hu. This place name is Nam Tau Hu. They've got so many menu, right? But mostly it's based on soy milk and maybe some coconut milk with durian dumpling. But I can show you guys what other people order, okay? All right, if you see this, make sure you subscribe to my channel, right? Hit like to this video. I mean, when you come to like the off screen, not the mainstream areas, right? At least you get to sit down nice and
get to rest a bit. Like, been walking a lot in Chinatown, like a lot of people, like hot weather, sweating, but here you can just like sit and chill.
Right, you have me to show you around anyway, right? At least you know how to get there. And this would be my cold soy milk with some
what
mang lak gap luk duai.
Sweet basil and the millet.
Now it's time for me to show you the most popular place in this Pangnam street. But before I'm actually walk there to my favorite food, right? This is a real Chinatown food called Gana Chai Het Hom. Actually, I'm not even sure which one is Gana Chai, right? But all of this is real Chinatown food. If it's not too much for you, maybe you can try.
Yeah.
But it's too much for a lot of us.
Even the local like us.
You have to be like my grandfather, like Chinese.
Yeah. Like old people.
Ancestor, right? All right, the place here called Khua Phor Lam Mai, I mentioned earlier, right? They serve everything in a hot pan like this, right? You have like omelette, you have like different type of noodles, lat na, noodles with gravies, or stir fry chicken with noodles and everything, right? But for me here, I will order Amy already. Okay, maybe I'm going to do this, right? Fry noodle seafood gravy here.
It's so good.
You see. It's only 100 baht in a hot pan. And this is now the exciting part of this video. Whoa. Here we go. All right, at this noodle place here, they have chili sauce, right? It's not go with this lat na, okay? If you guys confused. Also, this one is for sukiyaki only, okay? Don't put it in here, all right? Maybe this is still way too hot for me to eat right now. But this is sen yai, right? The large noodles, they kind of like fry pan it. So it's a little bit crispy on the outside, and in the inside it's still soft, but the gravy is, I bet it's extremely hot.
Because they're serving in a hot pan.
Yeah, too hot right now. เข้าใจ I will add some chili powder and a little bit of sugar. They also have eggs, but it's cooked until it's super well done now, I think. Walking back to the main street now. Actually, in Chinatown, there are many things for you to do and eat both day and night. All right, this is just one of the episodes. Be sure to hit subscribe, okay? Because later on, I will show you my recommendation on the daytime and 1, 2, and 3 little streets along Chinatown. Bye bye for now. My name is Chun, right? Emmy holding the cameras right now. Okay.